Welcome to Stella's Meza. On today's episode, I will show you how to make chicken kebab, which in Swahili we call mishkaki ya kuku. Okay? Now, for this, you will need to do this ahead of time. Like, I had to marinate my chicken overnight, and I had 1.5 pound of chicken breast, which I cubed, I cleaned out and cubed. And then to marinate, you will need 3 tablespoons of plain yogurt, not vanilla, not any other flavor, just plain heavy yogurt. And then you will need 1 teaspoon of ginger paste. You will need 1 teaspoon of garlic paste, which is just garlic that I peeled and cubed and use my mortar and pestle to make a paste out of. And you will need a pepper. Now, my choice is habanero pepper. And I buy these canned, and then I just go ahead and take the seeds out just to make the food not too spicy. And then I make a paste out of it. You will also need 1 tablespoon of cumin powder. You will need 1 teaspoon of coriander powder. You will need 2 tablespoons of lemon juice. And since I don't like my food too hot, I'd like to enjoy it a little, but feel the heat in the back, I put half a teaspoon of cayenne pepper. If you're brave, you can go for a whole teaspoon. Okay, it's all depending on choice. And I also have here 1 teaspoon of cinnamon powder. And I have here a little bit of salt. It depends on how salty you like yours. So I'm saying 1/2 teaspoon of salt. All right, now you will also need vegetable oil or any kind of oil. I use canola oil. And here I have cubed red pepper, and you need them right about that size. This is for the garnish, okay? And you also need onions. I use a whole onion, and then I cubed it. I made it to that about that size. And I also use green pepper, which I made to about that size. Now, when you take all these ingredients, you're gonna mix them in a bowl, and then cube your chicken, put them in that bowl, and give them a good mix, okay? Give them a good mix, that way the marinade coats the chicken. And then you're gonna add a couple drops of oil, okay? I added around 4 drops of oil, and then you're going to cover it up and refrigerate it overnight. You can do it for at least 3 hours, that way the chicken absorbs all the flavors, okay? Now, once that's done, over here, this is something you might need. If you like to barbecue, you can do this over the barbecue, but I want to do this in the house so you can see how it's done. So I use a grill pan. You can find these easily at any store, for example, Walmart. And there I have some grilling tongs. And also, overnight, I soaked, these are bamboo skewers that you use to make kebabs. I soak them overnight in just water, okay? I do this that way they do not burn. It's either you're grilling out in the open flames or you're using the grill pan, okay? So now I'm gonna show you how we're gonna skewer this. Always clean hands, and I did that. I scrubbed my hands, sorry, because you're about to handle raw food, okay? And you're gonna do the same after you cook. You make the skewer, you're gonna really wash your hands. So I have a chicken here. What I'm gonna do is alternate. I'm gonna do chicken, peppers, onions, chicken, pepper, onions. And we're gonna use the skewers, okay? So I'm gonna start the first. And look at what size chicken needs to be, around that size, okay? So I'm gonna start by putting that chicken in the skewer. Now, the reason you use lemon juice is to make the chicken tender, so you tenderize the chicken, okay? So now it's nice and tender, it's easy for the skewer to go through. Make sure you leave some space to handle your skewer with, okay? And then I'm gonna take the red pepper, green pepper. It's gonna get messy. Don't be scared to touch your food so long as your hands are clean. And then some onions. Okay, and then I'm gonna repeat the same thing. Chicken, red pepper, green pepper, and some onions. I'm doing 2 onions every time I put a layer of onions. You just keep going this way, okay? Now, this recipe is enough for 3 or 4 people. It's just me, my husband, and my son. So if you'd like to double it, depending on how much company you have over or how big your family is, go ahead and do that. Just double the amount of meat, but the spices, leave the spices the same amount, okay? You don't want too much spice in there. Alright, now this can be eaten with like an appetizer, basically. Okay, or if you like, you can make a side of rice, some aromatic rice, and something with stew in it, because this is dry, you can't just eat it with rice, okay? Alright, and you still want to leave that space in there. Look at that pretty skewer. It has all those colors in there. So we're going to take a break, and when we come back, I'll show you the next step, which is grilling them. I have my grill pan here on medium high. Now it covers both eyes of the stove, so it's heating up. And when you come back, we'll be ready to go ahead and cut these babies, okay? See you back soon. Welcome back. Right before the break, I was assembling the mishkakis or kebabs, chicken kebabs. And this is what they look like when they're all assembled. You can see the colors, that's beautiful, okay? We have the chicken, we have red pepper, green pepper, and then we have onion, just in that order, all right? So now over here, I had my grill pan heating up on medium heat, and I'm gonna start putting the mishkakis on the grill, okay? And if you like, actually you can add a little bit of oil on the grill, a couple of drops, and then use your grill brush to spread them around. Now this is a nonstick pan, I don't know that it'll make a difference, but just in case, because I don't want any stick, okay? I just pour them in there, and I'm going to keep doing that. And give them a little bit of space to cook. And you want to make sure they get those beautiful grill marks. So you keep cooking them this way. And then you turn and make sure that everything is cooked on all the sides, okay? Now I'm going to leave these on here because chicken takes a minute to cook. And then we'll be back and I'll show you the finished product. And see you right back. Welcome back. Right before the break, I was grilling these babies on the grill pan. And this is a complete product, okay? There's some still grilling on the pan. But you can see we have the beautiful grill marks on there. And then I'm going to pick one up so you can see it up close, okay? And it smells so good in the kitchen. It's a little bit smoky, but it smells really, really good, okay? And I'm going to pull one piece out. I'm going to use a fork to pull the last piece out. There you go. I'm going to take a bite. Wow, they're so good. Ooh, that's good. It has a little bit of kick in the end, but you can taste the cumin in there. And the other spices that add like layers of flavor on them. Ooh, that's really good. All right, I'm gonna stop and enjoy this. And I hope you join me next time when we make more dishes. And I want you to think and eat outside the box. Don't be scared to try new things, even if they have a weird name. You might really be surprised, okay? So I hope you enjoyed this episode for today. And join me next time as I take your taste buds on a culinary safari. Thank you.